does not have any argument. Okay, so here number is the default constructor member function, and in default constructor definition we have initialized the value of a variable a equals to 10 and b equals to 0, right? And then we have the normal method of object creation, number n, and then you have to see that we are not calling the constructor member function. So the thing is, when the constructor is when the object is created, the constructor will be invoked automatically, so no need to access it separately, right? So now let me execute this particular program. Okay, so a value is 10 and b value is 0. Okay, so since we have initialized the value of a as 10 and b as 0, this is the first program. So the second program is parameterized constructor, right? So for parameterized constructor, so the meaning is the constructor will be having arguments within it, then we are going to call it as parameterized constructor, right? And for parameterized constructor, the arguments will be assumed as a value of a variable. So inside the member function definition, I equals to a and b equals to j, right? So I and j are the argument which we are going to pass, and we have difference in terms of object creation. Why? Because the parameterized constructor cannot be invoked with the normal object creation, so either it has to go for implicit call or explicit call. So here we have the first one is the implicit call. Here for the object itself we need to pass the value, and this is the explicit call. Okay, so if we go like that, then the value of the variables will be assumed. So let me execute this program. Okay, so first a is 20 and b value is 30, and for the second object n2, a value is 30 and b value is 40, right? Okay, next the third type of constructor is copy constructor, right? Okay, so we have the copy constructor. So for copy constructor, the reference variable of the particular class will be passed as an argument. Okay, and for copy constructor, the definition is also different. With the help of the reference variable, we need to assume the value. So k.a and k.b. So inside the main program also, first we need to create the object for parameterized constructor, right? Why? Because we have the parameterized constructor here. And then we need to go for object creation of copy constructor. So the syntax for copy constructor object creation is also different, right? So class name space object name within bracket another object name, right? So that the value of that particular object will be copied to this particular object. So let us execute this. Okay, so a value is 30, b value is 40. This is for the first object creation for parameterized constructor. And second, for copy constructor, we have created the object. We have copied the value of the object n1 to this particular object. So the same value has been printed twice. Okay, and at last we have seen constructor overloading, right? So for area of the circle, area of the rectangle and area of the cube, we are doing in the single program only. Okay, so only three member functions we have. So the first member function is for area of the circle, so pi r square, and the second member function, area of the rectangle, two arguments we have, and area of the cube, three arguments we have. So inside the main program, we are creating three different objects. When the first object is created, for area of the circle, that particular parameterized constructor will be invoked. So here we are passing single argument of floating point type, and the second object y is created for the parameterized constructor area for area of the rectangle, where we are passing two values. So the two values are of integer data type. And the third object z has been created with three arguments, so that this particular values will be passed for area of the cube, where we have three arguments of integer type, right? So let us execute this. So we have three different values, and still this program we can modify. So here you can go for separate classes also you can go, okay? So that I will tell you. So later on during the inheritance concept we will discuss within a single program itself creating more than one class and how we can relate one class with another class. So those things we will see in the inheritance concept. Okay.